Shalom. And before I get into my lesson, I want to start off giving all praises to Yahweh, Mahashim, Yahweh Shai, Mahashim, Makash, Kadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders that rule well in the ministry of Yahweh, Mahashim, Yahweh Shai. And honors to the Akim, to the brothers that's on the highways and byways in the ministry uplifting the spirit and the power of Yahweh, Mahashim, Yahweh Shai, and faith and sincerity. This is Brother Shaquat Gabbar from the Great Millstone Charlotte Camp, coming at you with another lesson. And once again, the message is to you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, man, and those who bloodline go back to the Negro, Latino, and Native American descent on the father's side, man, the confused faces, man, that's scattered amongst the heathens, man. You know, so basically, man, I'm going to get into the scriptures about, you know, power, man, because that the Lord is, you know, all about, man. You know, and one of the things that he going to give us to have that power is the law, statutes, and commandments in our inward part, man. And mainly, man, believe it on his name, which is Yahweh, who the world called God. His son named Yahweh Shah, who the world called Jesus Christ, man. You know, so that's the beginning of the power, man. Knowing who the true power are, and knowing that he's only for the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man, which are the Israelites, man. And the word Israel means he, prince of power, man. So the Lord's going to give his man that power, man. Just like how he gave all his other men throughout the scriptures, you know, during the ancient times, power to glorify him, man. Like he glorified Moses, you know, King David, you know, Solomon, Elisha, Elijah, the 12 disciples, man. You know, the Lord, the Maccabees, the Lord always showed his strength and showed his power through spiritual power, through the men that believe on him, man, his elect men. And for those the ones that's going to get their power, man, only the elect men can get their spiritual power, man. And brothers in this faith, man, we praying to the Lord that he give us that power, man. Because that's the way that we're going to glorify the Lord. And also, that's going to be the way that we're going to do, you know, miracles, man, healing, you know, people, those that believe, man. And also, we're going to be, you know, need the power to defend ourselves from our enemies, man, the so-called white man. When he roll in on us with this RFID chip, a mark of the beast, with his martial law, you know, when he's trying to throw brothers in, you know, in the FEMA camps, man, you know, on when all hell break loose, man, we're praying that the Lord give us that power, man, because the Lord promised the nation of Israel power, man. Like I say, man, the nation of Israel, or the word Israel, when he, you know, Jacob, when he wrestled with the angel, man, you know, the Lord, you know, gave him a blessing, and the blessing that he gave him, he changed his name to Israel, meaning he, prince of power, and he had 12 sons, man, that represent the nation of Israel, man, and which are the Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans today, man. So we're looking for that power, man, and having faith that the Lord Yahweh Shai is going to give us, will give us that power, man. This is John chapter 14, verse 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, he do also. He shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. So you know that the Lord Yahweh Shai, man. He said those that believe on him, man. The elect men that believe on him had that faith in Yahweh Shai, man. He said the works that he did, that the men that believe on him going to do and greater, man. And what some of the counts that the Lord did in the scriptures, man. You know, he healed the, you know, the sick, the lame, you know, the crippled, you know, the blind, the deaf, the dumb. You know, he walked on water. You know, he disappeared and reappeared, man. You know, he read people's thoughts, man. You know, he turned water into wine. The Lord Yahweh Shai did, you know, so many things, man. He had so much power, man, that when a person came up to him and asked him, you know, the heal their loved ones that was sick back at home, man, you know, without them not there being in his presence, man, the only thing they had to do was have faith in Yahweh Shai. And once they returned home, man, their loved ones was healed, man. That shows you how much power that Yahweh Shai had, man. And Yahweh Shai is the first spirit created, man. He's the king of all kings, the Lord of lords, man. You know, the second under who the world called God, Yahweh, man. know, because the Lord, Yahweh, set and choose Yahweh Shah to be his son, man. And Yahweh Shah choose the elect men of Israel, man, the first fruits to be under him, man. That's why he said the things that he did, we're going to do greater, man. And praying that we part of that number, man. And that we, you know, continue on in his faith, man. And then one of the things that the Lord going to bless us with, besides the kingdom of heaven, is spiritual power, man. Which is going to be ruled by the kingdom of heaven, man. Power, man. You know? You know, because right now, man, you got, you know, the so-called white man, you know, he want to, you know, roll in with his army, man, thinking that, you know, that he's just going to, you know, come with his military and continue to oppress Jake, oppress the Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. You want to roll in on the men of the Lord and stop this truth, man, by trying to, you know, kill them, man, or murder them. But not knowing that the Lord, you know, got it set up. When he do come in, man, the Lord will give his men that spiritual power, man, to defend themselves, man. This is, basically, man, you know, brothers, you know, just had that faith, man, that the Lord is going to give us that power, man, when the enemy come in as a flood, man. This is on Isaiah chapter 59, verse 19. So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west and his glory from the rising of the sun, when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of Yahweh shall lift up a standard against him. And that word standard means, you know, the flight, the put to flight. You know, basically the Lord will give his man that power, man, to, you know, to put our enemies to flight, man. But the scripture also say that, that when our enemies come in, back in the ancient time, man, the Lord say our enemy came in, you know, one way. They came in one way in that military form, but they fled, you know, seven different ways, man. Meaning that the Lord gave his men that power, man, been with his men to defeat their enemies, man, and had their enemies, to run. When the Lord showed his power among the nation of Israel, man. In their mind, they thinking that they're going to defeat the Lord and his chosen people, man. Because Esau, man, he know that we are the chosen people, man. And he know that, you know, he's thinking that because got us in slavery, he thinking that, you know, he was going to, you know, keep us down, man. And when he come with his military, he thinking that he going to just conquer us again and keep us in subjection, not knowing that the Lord this time, man, the Lord's going to raise a standard up, man. You know, because the Lord said his people ain't going to be afflicted, you know, no more, man. This is, This is Michael. Michael chapter 4, verse 11. Now also many nations are gathered against thee, they that say, let her be defiled, and let our eye look upon Zion. So that was your so-called white people, man. You eat them, man. You know, you leak. You know, you got these plans of keeping the Negro, Latino, Native American down, man. Or trying to, you know, depopulate, you know, man, wipe us off the face of the earth, man, with your King Alpha plan of Agenda 21. How he pushes so much plague and so much, you know, destruction and, you know, and death amongst our people, man. You know, because you want to get rid of the nation of Israel, man. You know, thinking that you can get that birthright back that you lost as Esau, man, or as your forefather Esau lost, man, when the Lord took that birthright from him. He's supposed to be the firstborn. The eldest son, supposed to get the blessing. But the Lord reject Esau, man. And so you thinking in your mind these times, you thinking that if you can destroy the nation of Israel, Jacob, which Esau's brother, man, you thinking that you can destroy his children, man, who the promise was given to, you think that you will keep, you can get their inheritance back, man. But the Lord, like I said, gonna lift up a standard, man. And against also against you other heathen nations too, man. That's gonna be over here with them foreign troops like the Chinese, you know, the NATO, or Russian troops, you know, Japan troops, these African troops, man, that's gonna be over here during the time of martial law, man. The Lord's gonna lift up that standard against y'all, man. Y'all think y'all gonna keep Israel down, man. Verse 12. But they know not the thoughts of the Lord, neither understand his counsel. So the heathens, man, the enemies, they don't know the thoughts of the Lord, man. In their mind, they think they're going to keep conquering the nation of Israel, man, and keep the Negro, Latinos, and Native Americans down, man. But they don't know the mind of the Lord, man, or understand his counsel. And these scriptures, meaning these scriptures, man, they don't understand the scriptures, man. They don't understand that the Lord is going to raise up the nation of Israel, man, the elect, with that power, man, to defeat them, man. For he shall gather them as sheaves into the floor. Verse 13. Arise and thrust, O daughter of Zion, for I will make thy horn iron, and I will make thy hoof brass. Thou shalt beat in pieces many people, and I will consecrate their gain unto the Lord, and their substance unto the Lord of the whole earth. So we know the Lord is going to protect us, man. You know, he's going to make our horn, mean horn represents power, iron, man. So he's going to make us tough, man. He's going to give us that angelic body, man. And he's going to give us the body that we can, you know, won't be penetrated by any bullets or tanks or, you know, swords or sticks, man. Listen, man, we could be untouchable, man. And he's going to make our hoof brass, another, you know, tough metal, man. You know, a hoof represent your foot, man, or your feet. From head to toe, man, the Lord's going to make us, you know, basically he's going to make us, you know, like a man of steel, man. Make us, you know, a power, man. To, you know, to put fear throughout these other nations, man. You know, 144,000, man, going to be raised up as a Superman on the earth, man, to conquer this world, man. And the Lord said we're going to consecrate their gain, meaning we're going to take all their resources, man. And that's how we're going to inhabit our kingdom, man. We're going to take it by force, man. You know? This is on Daniel chapter 7, verse 18. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. So the Lord said, you know, the saints of the Most High, starting off with the elect, you know, of the nation of Israel, man, we're going to take the kingdom, man. And that was, you know, and we're going to possess it forever, man. We ain't never going to lose our kingdom, man, or our status, or our heritage again, man. You know, we're going to take it, man. Just like how King David, his mighty man, was, you know, once that during that time when David was ruling, how they was conquering all the nations, man, the heathen nations, they're going to come back again, man. You know, because the Lord is going to raise up King David again, man. You know, and he's going to set up his army in the house of David once again to conquer these heathen nations, man. This is Isaiah chapter 40, verse 27. Why sayest thou, O Jacob, and speakest, O Israel, my way is hid from the Lord, my judgment is passed over from my power? And then we got a lot of our people saying, man, you Negro, Latino, Native Americans, man, y'all don't believe in a higher power, man. Y'all don't think the Lord can deliver you from out of the situation in America or wherever you're at throughout the world, man. Y'all don't think that the Lord, you know, cares for you, man, or love you, man, not knowing that the reason why we in the low state, man, our rebellious and our transgressions against the law, statutes, commandments, and going against Yahweh, Bashir, Yahweh, Shah, man. So you coming back, repenting to the Lord, man, and the Lord going to have mercy. And we praying that we be part of his elect, man. He going to raise those same men up, man, the elect man up, that Hashem Yahweh Shah, man. But the Lord don't love everybody, man. He only cares for the nation of Israel, man. The Negro, Latino, and Native American. Verse 28. Hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting power, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He give power to the faint and to them that have no might. He increased strength. So those that, because you know, Negro, Latino, Native Americans, man, you are in a low state, man. You know, so we're looking for Yahweh Bashmiah Shai to increase our strength, man. The Lord gonna give us that you know, that ultimate strength, man. Strength that's unmeasurable, until, you know, what the Lord gonna give us, man. Like Samson, man. You know, they had that strength that these people couldn't fathom, man. You know, slaying thousands and thousands of Philistines, man. You know, doing stuff that these people couldn't fantasize, something that could come out of a Marvel movie, man. You know, you just now had that movie, Avengers, Infinite War, with Thanos came, and basically, man, Thanos represented Yahweh Shah, man. Like, he came back and conquered all the known heroes that was on the earth, man. Like, he came back and conquered with the Infinity Stone. Know which are the, you know, represent the elements, man, and that's Yahweh Shah, because Yahweh Shah control all elements, man, from the water, you know, fire, you know, wind, you know, the earth, you know, the healing, you know, Lord Yahweh Shah got all power in his hand, man, and that's why, you know, most of these Marvel movies or comics, man, or any of these animation, man, they get all these resources from the Holy Scriptures, man, because the Scripture is the first, you know, first known. When you want to, you know, compare the super spiritual power or action or Marvel movies or something or comics, man, the Scriptures are the first thing that that matter, man. Because in these Scriptures, man, the accounts of these supernatural things actually took place, man. You know, these movies are just a fantasy of what they thinking about, man. But not knowing that the Scripture actually play these things out, man, when it comes to spiritual power, man. He give power to the faint and to them that have no might. He increased strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, but the young man shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon Yahweh shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. You know, so basically, man, waiting on the Lord, man, the Lord gonna raise his elect up, man, those that sighing and crying, man. You know, because you got 2/3 of our people, they're not looking for the Lord, man, on truth and sincerity, man. They believing in America. They believe in these false idols, man, the idol gods, man. You know, but those that believe on the true power, the Lord is gonna hear them and renew their script, man. You know, those that believe on Yahweh Shah, man, you know, and he gonna renew their script and say they gonna mount up with wings as eagles, man. Meaning they're going to be able to fly, man, to soar throughout the sky, man. And we believe in that, man. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. So we're going to have unlimited speed, man. Unlimited stamina, man. Ultimate stamina, just, you know, run to and fro, man. You know, like the Scriptures say, man. Another precept. This is Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 5, verse 17. He shall take to him his jealousy for a complete armor to make the creature his weapon for the revenge of his enemy. And he shall put on righteousness as a breastplate and true judgment instead of a helmet. And he shall take holiness for an invincible shield. So basically, man, you know, that Scripture proves right there, man, that the Lord gonna make his elect man that complete armor, man, and make the creature, which is the elect, his weapon for revenge of his enemies. So he gonna make the nation of Israel, man, as a battle axe, a weapon of war, armor, power, man, to defeat his enemies, man. And the number one enemy is you so-called white people, man, starting out with you elites and the rest of you heathen nations, man. This is Jeremiah 51, verse 19. The portion of Jacob is not like them, for he is the former of all things. And the portion represents the elect, man. The 144,000 and one-third of you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, the elect. You know, praying, you know, brothers that in this faith that we be part of that number, man. Because we were inherited that power, man, that spiritual power, man. The portion of Jacob is not like them, for he is the former of all things. And Israel is the ride of his inheritance. The Lord of hosts is his name. Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war. So the Lord preparing this man. He's not saying that we're going to use battle axe and weapons of war. No, we're going to have weaponry, but the Lord said that we're going to be the weapon, man. When Esau got these counter weapons like the gun, you know, the tank, the fighter jet, you know, the flamethrower, the, you know, the missiles, you know, the bombs, you know, the grenades and all that, man. And but the Lord said he going to set his man up, the nation of Israel, the elect man, as being the weapon, man. We ain't going to need no guns or no tanks or no fighter jets, man. The Lord going to straight give us the spirit of power, man, to manipulate the elements, man, shooting fire out of our eyes, man, our mouth, you know, our hand, you know, controlling the element of ice, you know, water, you know, the earth, you know, the air, wind. Is that what we're looking for, man? Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war, for with thee will I break in pieces the nation, and with thee will I destroy Canaan, and with thee will I break in pieces the horse and his rider, and with thee will I break in pieces the chariot and his rider, going into their military, man. With thee also will I break in pieces man and women, so women ain't a zimp, man. Lord will give his men that power, man, to destroy men and women, man. You know, and with thee will I break in pieces old and young, meaning old men, young children, man, because the majority of these people out here are wicked, man. And the Lord put his power, his spirit on his men. We're going to be righteous judges, man, to bring judgment upon the wicked of our people and the wicked of the earth, which are you heathens, man, starting off with you Edomites, man, you so-called white people. And with thee will I break in pieces the young man and the maid, and with thee will I also I will also break in pieces with thee the shepherd and his flocks. All these false, you know, Israelite camps, man. All these, you know, false, you know, teachers, man. All these pastors in the church, man. That represent the shepherd and the flock, man. You know, cause y'all misleading the people, man. Y'all telling the lies, man. Especially you know, Israelite camps that out there that proclaiming that you know the scriptures, but you twisting the scriptures, man. Telling deceitful lies on the scriptures, and you know, basically, you know, going against the true way of breaking out of the scriptures that Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah have, man. You know, so the Lord gonna destroy y'all also too, man, by the way of his men with that power, man. With thee will I break in pieces the husband and his yoke and oxen, and with thee will I break in pieces captains and rulers. You know, so the government, big government, small government, you know, all these that got a high position and against, you know, they're here in America and against the scriptures, or against Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, the Lord gonna have his men destroy this place, man. You know, and Yahweh Shah also gonna destroy this place, you know, too, and different other kingdoms. And after Yahweh Shah come back, man, Lord gonna set up the nation of Israel, and the elect man is gonna go around the earth putting these heathen nations in captivity, man, from Europe, you know, China, you know, Australia, Russia, India, you know, Africa. You putting all you nations in the captivity, man, through spiritual power, man, when the Lord give his man that okay, man. And America gonna be destroyed, man, by thermonuclear fire, man. And right to that, man, we're gonna enslave you heathen nations, man. Starting off with the elites, man, you super rich bankers. Verse 24. And I will render unto Babylon to all the inhabitants of Chaldea, and all the evil that they had done unto Zion in your sight, see Yahweh. You know, so they're talking, the modern day Babylon talking about America, man. Don't you know, come back then in America, I mean, back in the ancient Babylon, which was ruled by the Babylonians, man. You know, the Assyrians, and you know, the Hamites, and these other heathen nations. Back then, when we was under the Babylonians during that time, man, we had no power, man. You know, and on top of that, the Persians and the Medes came into power to take down the Babylonian Empire, man. Proving that this modern-day Babylon today is talking about America, man. Because we didn't have power to fight against the Babylonians during that time, man. And the Persian, the Medes came into power and took down it, like I said, took down the Babylonian Empire, man. So they're talking about this time, man, the Lord going to raise us up, man, with that power, man. This is Revelation chapter 11, verse 3. And I will give power unto my two witnesses, and the two witnesses represent the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom, man. The two kingdoms of nation of Israel, man. And they shall prophesy 1,260 days clothed in sackcloth. And that's what we have it now, man. We, you know, brothers out there prophesizing, man. From the all tribes of the nation of Israel, man. From the Negro, Latino, and Native Americans, man. And these are the two olive trees and the two candlesticks before the power of the earth. You know, if any man will hurt them, fire proceeded out of their mouth and devoured their enemies. And if any man will hurt them, he must, in this manner, be killed. So, you know, the Lord will give his men, man, the northern kingdom, the southern kingdom, basically the elect, man, that power, man, to come against their enemies, man, when the enemy come in as a flood, or when they come against the men of the Lord, man. If that will represent the two, you know, candlestick and the olive tree, man, the northern kingdom, which is considered, you know, the Puerto Ricans, the Native Americans, the Seminole Indians, the Mexicans, you know, and so forth, man, which are Israelites, and the southern kingdom are, you know, Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, which are the Negroes, the West Indians, Jamaicans, and the Haitians, man. The elect men, out of those 12 tribes of Israel, the Lord gonna give them that power, man, to fight against their enemies, man. This have power to shut heaven, that it rain not in the days of their prophecy, and have power over waters to turn into blood, and to smite the earth for all plagues as often as they will. So the Lord will give his man that ultimate power, man, to do anything they want to do in righteousness through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, man. You know, so the Lord will give his man that spiritual power, man. Brothers that's in the faith, man, keep pushing, keep fighting, man. Praying that we, you know, part of that electment that was coming to the nation of Israel, man. Because once again, Israel, meaning he's Prince of Power, man. The Lord is going to give us that power, man, because that's what the Lord chose us to be, man. A royal seed, man, above all nations, man, to have authority, man, over these other nations, you know. And the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah, ain't nothing but power, man. But the only thing we got to do is repent, you know, and pray to the Lord to have mercy upon us, man. You know, we got to, that's what we go out on the highways and byways, man. We glorifying the Lord, man, when we pushing this word, showing that we want his mercy, and showing that we also want that power, man. And when we glorify the Lord gonna glorify us in that with that power, man. This is Psalms. This is Psalms 110 and verse 3. I'm gonna start off at verse 1. The Lord say unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand until I make thy enemies thy footstool. So this is talking about Yahweh Shah, man. The Lord shall send thy rod of thy strength out of Zion, meaning out of the nation of Israel, man. That's who the rod, the rulership is going to come from, man. The nation of Israel, man. The Negro, Latino, and Native American, starting off with the elect. Rule thou in the midst of thy enemy. Thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power. in the bitterness of holiness from the womb of the morning, thou had a due of thy youth. The Lord say, thy people mean that our people gonna be willing, and thy power mean when the Lord raises man over that power, man, then when our people, majority of our people gonna wanna, you know, wanna get down with the program, man. And when the Lord show himself through his men, man, they ain't gonna be doing all that scoffing and scorning, that mocking. You know, but by that time, man, the Lord ain't gonna have mercy upon them, man. Majority of them are gonna be destroyed, man. But you're gonna have some of them, they're gonna be part of the 1/3 that's gonna, you know, believe, man. They're gonna believe and be, you know, converted to believing in Yahweh Bashim Yahusha. But that's how the Lord had converted people back then when Yahusha was walking with him. You know, he made the people believe on him by the way of that spiritual power, man. And his disciples woke up a lot of people also, you know, by the way of the spiritual power, man. So, you know, we in the, you know, the apostles always say that we in the time of Acts all over again, man. And this is a wonderful act, seeing the nation of Israel, man, being raised up, man, and going on the highways and byways and pushing and proclaiming the truth of Yahweh Bashim Yahusha. And the next thing the Lord going to give his man is that spiritual power, man. And pray the Lord willing that, you know, we beat on men. And we got to have that faith, man. It surely is coming, man. So brothers, you know, we're going to keep fighting, keep pushing, man. And the day of our power is coming, man. Yahweh Shai is going to return and deliver the nation of Israel, man, the elect. And we pray that we part of that number, man. So keep fighting and keep pushing, man. You know, Bahashim Rakah Kodash, man. Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, Bahashim Rakah Kodash, man. Keep pushing and keep fighting, man. You know, so next time we give all praise to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. Hashem, Rakah, Kadosh, double honor to the apostles and elders for teaching us this wonderful truth, man. The blessing, the men, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashim Yahusha, with this truth, man. And just keep fighting, keep pushing, man. You know, honor to the Aki and the brothers that's on the highways and byways, that's in the faith and the ministry, man. Looking for that power to come, man. So we is going to get that power, man. Just keep fighting and believing, man. You know, keep praying for each other. You know, keep pushing this word, man. Keep going fire. Yahweh Bashim Yahusha. Yahweh Bashim Yahusha is going to glorify us. Till the next time, Shalom.